Hi everyone, I'm Rajan Chaudhary from Manzil Immigrations. Today I will talk about exams required to pursue vocational courses in Canada. For vocational courses in Canada, you need to first understand the eligibility requirements. Unlike degrees, courses, you don't have to give standardized exams like GMAT or GRE. To get admission in Canadian universities, international applicants need to clear either of the English proficiency tests. These tests only check your language efficiency and not quant or reasoning skills. So, the preparation time required is less. The English language tests accepted for vocational courses are: first of all, I will talk about TOEFL, Test of English as Foreign Language, TOEFL, measures the ability of non-native speakers of English to use and understand North American English as it's spoken, written, and heard in college and university settings. The TOEFL test is developed and administered by Educational Testing Service, ETS, which sets the questions, conducts the test, and sends each examinee the score report. TOEFL exam is required for admission at colleges and universities where medium of instruction is English. Apart from the academic's purpose, many government agencies, scholarship programs, and certification agencies use TOEFL scores to evaluate English proficiency. If I talk about TOEFL exam pattern, four sections, namely reading, listening, speaking, and writing, along with the total score. International English Language Testing System, means IELTS, is an English language proficiency exam that measures the language ability of candidates willing to study or work in a country where English is the language of communication. The exam mainly assesses the ability of test takers to communicate in the four basic language skills: listening, reading, speaking, and writing. Apart from the academic purposes, many government agencies, scholarship programs, and certification agencies use IELTS scores to evaluate English proficiency. You can take IELTS exam with the British Council up to once a week, four times a month. The British Council global schedule for global test dates is 48 days per year. However, if a candidate is not satisfied with his scores, he can take the exam again after 3 months from the date of the first exam. If I talk about IELTS exam pattern, four sections are there, namely reading, speaking, listening, writing, along with the IELTS total score. The total score is the sum of the scores in the four skill areas. IELTS exam is available in two patterns: academic or general. Students need to take the academic test, and other applicants who need IELTS results for visa or scholarship purposes need to take general test. Here we cover the academic test pattern: ELA, English Language Assessment Test, CAEL, Canadian Academic English Language Assessment Test. The Canadian Academic English Language Assessment, CAEL, is a standardized test of English in use to academic purposes. It's designed to describe the level of English language of test takers planning to study in English medium colleges and universities. The CAEL assessment tests ability to use English as it is used in Canadian universities and colleges. It allows test takers to experience what it is like to participate in a Canadian post-secondary classroom. Now, I will talk about PTE. PTE Academic is a computer-based test. which assess the listening, reading, speaking and writing abilities of non-native speakers of English who need to demonstrate their academic English capability. Often, to obtain places at English-speaking universities, higher education institutes, or as proof of their language ability for a visa application. You know, PTE academic scores are assessed via an online account. You will receive an email notifying you once your scores are available. After you receive this, you will need to log in to the Pearson account that you created to book your test. Now, scores for communicative skills, listening, reading, speaking and writing are based on all test items that assess these skills, either as a single skill or together with other skills. So, the range for each communicative skill score is 10 to 90 points. Scores for enabling skills, grammar, oral, fluency, pronunciation, spelling, vocabulary, and written discourse are based on all test items assessing one or more of these skills. The range for each enabling skill score is 10 to 90 points. Is it? So, if you have any kind of query, you can share your query in the comment section. I will do my best to answer you as soon as possible. And you can also share your profile on my WhatsApp number 9914615605. I will do my best to answer you as soon as possible. We will tell you which course is better for you, which university is better for you, which country is better for you, and what is better for you. Is it? Thank you so much. Be happy and take care.